Hello and welcome to Let's Play Master of Darkness. I'm Duke of the Bump. And we need to uncover the mystery behind some horrible events. Master of Darkness was a game released for the Sega Master System, and it is a complete Castlevania ripoff. You know, there's really no getting around that fact. But it's really good. I like it a lot. The story is fairly recent. More recent than the Castlevania games, anyway. You play a psychologist named Dr. Social. That's right. This game is the forces of psychology versus the supernatural. And you discover your leads with your handy-dandy Ouija board. Just like all good psychologists. Okay, the story for this game is pretty goofy, but the game's actually really fun. Oh shit! Whoa, so fucking scary. Alright, let's get this game underway. We have one more cutscene. Telling us the nature of a gruesome murder. A murder so gruesome that the body was completely drained of blood. Dr. Social knew there was something supernatural there. His Ouija board told him so. Makes perfect sense. Calling on the powers of the Ouija board. And so, let's go to the Thames River. Yes, it is Thames and not Thames, which is how I pronounced it for most of my life before somebody graciously corrected me. There are a number of weapons power-ups you can get in this game, as well as sub-weapons. I really don't need it, but there's a potion here to heal you. Of all the weapons, the one that I have is actually my favorite. I'm not really sure what it is, but I call it a hammer, because it sort of looks like a hammer. It might be like a hatchet or a billy club or something like that. I don't know. Other weapons that you can get include, the bow just kind of sank. There's a dagger that you start out with. There's an axe, which is right there. I don't want it. The axe is pretty good. It's as powerful as the hammer, but it doesn't have quite as much range, so. There's a sword, which has really good range, but it's not very powerful. There's, you know, the sub-weapons. I just picked up a gun, which is okay. It's not my favorite sub-weapon. As you can see, the style of this game is very reminiscent of Castlevania. The graphics are better. But, you know, this game was released years after Castlevania was, so, you know, they had a chance to sort of improve on that. I've beaten this game before, but I don't, you know, I didn't memorize the location of all the secrets, so I'll be hitting random walls looking for them. There's lots of stuff hidden in the walls. You can find health, sub-weapons, regular weapons, one-ups sometimes. This gun only has one speed, and that speed is glacial. Those bullets, can they move any slower? Any more slowly? Well, they could. But it would be a violation of the laws of physics. Those little orbs that you pick up, they just give you points. They don't really do much. Like most games, points aren't really worth anything. Unless you're playing for high score, which I guess you could. I don't see why. Alright, this is my second favorite sub-weapon in the game. The bomb, or the grenade. It's pretty nice. You can throw it upwards, and it does good amounts of damage. If you couldn't hear me there, I said it does good amounts of damage. It's not the best sub-weapon in the game, but it's, we won't find the best one until very, very close to the end of the game. That's a sword, which I don't want. Pretty much the only gripe I have about this game is that it's actually possible to downgrade your weapon. If you're not paying attention, then you can pick up a dagger, and you know, it gets rid of the weapon you have, and it gives you the crappy dagger that you start out with. Which is really not very fair. Hope I don't fall off there. Okay, good. Nothing down here? Curses. Not sure what the deal with these zombies are. Maybe they're the reanimated corpses of the grisly murder victims. Damn it. The most annoying enemies in every game like this is always... See, there's the dagger that we don't want. The most annoying enemies are always the animals. I don't want that either. You know, you can face madmen with guns, you can face flesh-eating zombies, but, you know, they're easy. And the ones you really gotta watch out for are the freaking animals. They move quickly, they're hard to hit, and they do just as much damage as bullets or zombie bites or whatever. Good old video game staples. Mess that guy up. There are 5 rounds in this game. Each one is divided into... Oops, that was a 1-up that I missed. Each round is divided up into 3 levels, except for the last one, which means that there's a total of 13 levels in this game. It's fairly long. It's not as long as some of its contemporaries, perhaps, but, but it's pretty good. Man, it really wants me to have that dagger, doesn't it? Not sure what the deal with those floating masks are either. That's sort of an odd place to hide power-ups. Alright, and I suppose that's as good a place to stop as any, so I will see you next time on Let's Play Master of Darkness. I'm Duke of the Bump. Later.